Well, they're heating up to 220. See what happens. Sits you right there, I think. You see everything. Better, more light. Up to 130.
No choice.
Smell it getting warm. 46, 50.
I'm just
leaving. 175.
Feedback.
I don't know why it's going to 220. I thought I set it for 210.
Looking for nothing.
198, 201.
I got 210.
I see a blinky blue light down there. 220. 222. 221. Doing something. I don't know why it went clear over there. Well, I guess the extruder's working. Yeah, that's a pile of hay. Well, we'll let it stop. Let it stop. Well, that was our first print. For some reason or another, it was like way too high off the bed.
Yes. On one condition.
Well, the fan works. It's cooling it off. I'm not gonna touch it, but yeah, it's hot. Alright, well, apparently we got some more calibrations to do, or maybe I had it set to print that high. Hell, I don't know. Whoop! We'll be back later. This part just blows me away. Whoop. So we're going to tell it to print. Oh, hold on. Let's reset it. We'll edit this out. Alright, so this just kind of blows me away. I went through Cura, the firmware, the motors, recalibrated, re-leveled it. It's like dead on. I mean, I put a piece of paper in there, it just barely drags, so it knows where the bottom is. So, we're going to tell it to print from the SD card one more time. Okay. So as you can see, start with. It gets to, maybe 5 millimeters off the bed, give or take, and then it slightly goes up. Now it's about 50 millimeters off the bed. No idea what it's doing here, but whatever. And it comes in real close. It slows down. Gets to about 10 millimeters off the bed. And then it goes up to about, I'd say 50. And then it waits for the temp to heat up to 220. Again, I have no idea why it's heating up to 220. It's set to go to 200. Firmware is set to 200. Cura is set to go to 200. Sliced it, told it to go to 200. But it's going to 220. I don't know. We'll wait for it to heat up. Why again it's going to 220? I have no idea. At about 180, you can see it's starting to ooze. I don't know why it oozes so early. Well, 220, so now it's at temp. Still just kind of hangs out a little bit. And then it goes up. It's way over here to Y for some reason. And it's just sitting there about 15 millimeters off, just oozing all over the place. No idea. And then it'll go back over to about 60 millimeters high. And it goes up to like 60, and then it comes back over here to like 40, 30. It's way out of whack. See, it comes down there like 20 mil. In the back there, it goes up to about 60. Comes over here to down about 20. That's supposed to be a pyramid. I'm gonna go ahead and stop it. Tell it to go home. No freaking idea. Three different prints. Tried a pyramid, tried a cube, tried a calibration block. You can see all my prints. That one there is actually the cube. That looks pretty good for a cube, I think. This was the calibration cube, I believe. Or not calibration cube, calibration block. And then this is the pyramid. I'd say out of all of them, the cube here, this 20 millimeter by 20 millimeter cube is my favorite. What the fuck? Well, it's 4:47 in the morning. I have been at this for 9 hours. And that's what I got to show for it. Comes down. That means I can put a piece of paper and just barely drags at zero, a bed level at all six corners, well, the triangle, whatever you call it, pentagram. And yeah. No idea why it comes up here in the back and then down here and then over here and then up and then down. I mean, it's acting like the bed's. Oh yeah, James at AnyCubic got back to me. Told me I needed to use an older version of Adreno. I already figured that out. got the firmware to load. Honestly, I'm almost thinking I'm just gonna cut this firmware and go right over to Ripeter. This one's been nothing but a hassle since I started. I mean, calibration, bed leveling, the extruder, everything's perfect. It's kind of sticking out there a little bit. But as soon as I go to print, like I said, it's at an angle when it prints. And even the low end is still like 20 millimeters off the bed. Maybe I missed something. I'll check the firmware one more time tomorrow and I think we'll be making a new cover here that says anything but AnyCubic, because damn. I'm still running off the little 5-volt power brick. Haven't wired in the power supply yet. I haven't seen any reason to get wild and crazy yet. I was hoping to build the, what do you call it? The front end piece for the power supply that has the holes cut out in it for the power switch, the power plug in it. And then I was going to build a bracket where it sits in it. Well, this would actually be at the bottom, I guess. Yeah, didn't get that built. As far as hardware goes, I can't complain. I think it's all in the firmware. Firmware and the slicing, something's just off. I'd seen one where they're in here and they're actually adjusting the voltages of the motors. Good grief, it can't be off that bad. I mean, I figured I could at least print something sloppy. I mean, I know a few people that have 3D printers. They put it together, they don't even load the firmware, and they just put a build in it with the SD card and build it. It comes out really rough, but it prints what it's supposed to be. Yeah, not so much in my case. I'm not even sure if that's losing out enough. Kind of stringy. Well, I don't know. Kind of pissed off. Looks pretty. Frack. So, I guess I'm going to edit software and, well, no, screw that. I'm going to bed. Then I'm going to lunch tomorrow. This late, by the time I wake up, it'll be breakfast. But they're going to call it lunch. And then, I'll edit the software, these videos, and start posting them. Really disappointed, I must say. Night. Alright, so I found one little error that I had done. I had the heat bed settings turned on in the slicer, so I was waiting for the heat bed. Set to 60 and it couldn't heat up because it was off. Duh, I know you were all sitting there yelling at me, hey, turn the heat bed off. Yeah, I've got it. Anyway. Power on. And fan is running, blue lights, red light. Of course, I have no idea what those lights mean. It'd be nice if the manual told me what the board did. A bunch of other lights down there for the heater and stuff, but yeah, anyway. I have no idea. Print from SD card. That's 24 I've seen, I don't know. Let's try the 15 one. This is Cura version 1.5 or 15 or whatever the hell it was. Heating set to 195. Oh, look at that, it's going. And then it should home. So when it gets up to about 190-ish, I'm going to put my hand on the off button. And of course, we're just kind of sitting here. I did not home it. It is set to G28 in the slice, so it should do that all on its own. It's heating up pretty good. Anyways, if you're wondering, is I'm vaping. Beat smoking. Anyway, we're up to about 165-ish. Should start doing something. Here, oh, there's a blue light down there blinking. I'm assuming that means almost a temp. I don't know. But 197, 198. Scared me. Well, there's the home that it was supposed to do, and you see it started to extrude a little bit. I'm actually going to clean that off. Let's hope it doesn't hit the bed. Let's hope it's not 50 millimeters in the air. Oh, wait, what are we doing? Holy cow. It didn't do the brim though. Oh, wait, maybe that brim's that outside one there. Oh my goodness, I think we found it. Well, shit. We're down here at the timer. I don't know why it says 0.01. But I'll go ahead and set you right here. Actually, I'm going to check my battery. Of course, my battery's weak. I plug it in, but the way it's set up, it friggin' stops the record, and I'm already printing. I'll probably lose part of this, and then I'll come back to it. But hey, looky, it's printing. And it's doing a really, really nice job. Nice smooth edges, nice layers. Let's go in here so we get a better view of what I have. So about a quarter after it should be done. Just so those of you that know, there's another blue light over there for the heater. It's blinking while it's printing. The two blue lights that are always on, and then the red light. Now, from what I can see, it is stuck very good. Oh, no, it's not. I'll take that back. Over here on this edge, it is not stuck down. See, when it gets over here, you'll see it move. See it? So it's not stuck to the bed. But that's okay. It's printing. We can fix the glue and the adhesion later. But it's printing. That's holy snickerdoodles. It's flying. Wow. Whatever the clock needs, we're up to 3. I'm assuming 3 minutes. That's 3 minutes in. It's not vibrating, it's not bouncing all over. You're actually sitting. Here, I'll show you. I have my camera sitting right here on this edge. So any movement, you're going to be bouncing all over. So you'll know before I do. Just to get you a little closer in there, it's got you. That right corner there, you can see is lifted up. The other three corners look good. It looks, I'm happy with this. For first print, first actual on the bed printing. interesting how it's doing the infill. I don't know if you can see it. It's got a little cube in the middle and then four triangles that it's doing. So it's actually hollow. That's kind of cool. I did the honeycomb infill. Oh, the whole thing lifted off the bed. I can see it moving. Aww. It didn't stick. But it's my own fault. I put that glue on there last night. Yep, it just moved. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and stop it. It just screwed up. And stop. Auto home. Yeah, you can see it lifted up. But hey. Oh, it. So I told it to stop, but it keeps the heater up there. Alright, I'm gonna kill the power. Turn it back on just so it cools. But look at that, it did the little brim going around. Wow. Let's see if that's 20 mil. Get my calipers out. Oop, too far. Let's check the other side here. I think when I did that one side, you can see there was some overhang from when it bounced off the table. So 20.1, you can see the lines through it. I am tickled pink. Now you can see where it's doing those four triangles and that square in the middle. So yeah, I'm gonna go clean my bed off. Rubbing alcohol, put some new sticky on. Oh yeah, that's just dry. We'll start it up again with a charged battery.